So we welcome all our professors. All our colleagues, our guests here present, we welcome you to the 98th Inaugural Lecture of Nnamdi Azikiwe University, Oka. Happening live at the University Auditorium. We welcome you. You can see the chairman of the inaugural lecture committee. You can also see the 98th inaugural lecturer coming in, and of course our own dear vice chancellor is also here. He's ably represented by the DAP Professor Angela Ufele. Thank you. We take the university song Professor immediately. Nkemdili. While standing, may I respectfully invite Reverend Professor Emmanuel Umezinwa to lead us in the opening prayer.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Our help is in the name of the Lord. God, we thank you for today. We thank you for the gift of our university, staff and students. We thank you for this occasion which adds to the beauty of this wonderful month of Christmas. We ask you to come and bless us one and all in all we do. Bless our lecturer for today, Professor A.U. Nnonyelu. Bless all of us gathered here in our work, in our families, and in all we do. Grant us protection throughout this season and even beyond, so that in all that we do, in all that we say, and in all that we think, glory may be yours and your blessings eternally ours through Christ our Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Thank you very much, our own dear Reverend Father Professor Emmanuel Umezinwa, the Vice Chancellor Peter University. We salute you. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, please permit me to welcome in a special way the chairman of today's event and the vice chancellor of our great university, Professor Charles Okechukwu Simone, fellow Academy of Science, ably represented today by the director of academic planning of our great university, Professor Angela Ufele. Please may we appreciate the vice chancellor. Thank you. Thank you and welcome. I may also inform us that the wife of the vice chancellor is also here, Associate Professor Chinyere Esimone. We welcome you. The chairman of the inaugural lecture committee is also with us, ably represented today by Professor Mike Ezenwa. We salute you. So we have our professors here present, and we wish to also welcome all of us because this is a pure academic program. And in no particular order, please permit me to recognize our professors here present. So before we can continue, and of course, some other people. We have here Professor Romi Okoye. We welcome you. Our own dear retired professor, but not tired. You are welcome. We have in our midst the Dean of the Faculty of Education, Professor Vivian Wobo. We salute you. We also have the Dean of the Faculty of Arts, Professor Nwamara Alvan Ikoku Nwamara. We salute you, we thank you, and we welcome you. The director of Achike Okoli Center for Entrepreneurial Studies is also here, Professor Ada Omeni. We welcome you. We have in our midst Professor Alex Asibo, the director of General Studies. We salute you. We welcome you. The former resident electoral commissioner for Imo State is also here with us, Professor Emeka Ezonu. I salute you. We also have Professor Okibo. He's also here and is a great friend. You know, we welcome you, sir. Please let us appreciate him. Professor Dolly Adima is also here, the director Center for Sustainable Development. We salute you. Permit me to welcome in a special way the Vice Chancellor of Peter University, our own dear Professor, Reverend Father Professor Emmanuel Umezinwa. I salute you. I also have immediate past Dean of Faculty of Agriculture, Professor Nkiru Melodo. We thank you. The director of Unizik FM is also here, Professor Ifoma Dunu. And then a professor of laws is also there, Professor Felicia Anyogu. I salute you. I can also see Professor Nkechi Okpalobi is also here with us. Please may we appreciate her. You are welcome. We have Professor Anthony Nwokoye. Prof, we salute you. We welcome you. And beside him is Professor Joseph Atobuagu, the immediate provost, Federal College of Education, Technical Umunze. We salute you. Professor Gochuku Ibeneme is also here. We salute you, Prof. We also have Professor Mike Odi, we salute you, sir. We welcome you, our director. And also Professor Emenike Obi is also here, former SA to the Executive Governor of Anambra State. We salute you. The former Vice Chancellor of Enugu State University, is also here. Professor Luke Anike, we welcome you. No, na ebe dukwa ka we ba go ma rebel. But can name. We also have in no particular order this time, please. Professor Peter Ezia is also here. We salute you. We also have in our midst Professor Uche Ajato. I salute you. Professor Bentina Matias is also here. I salute you. Professor Neka Oli, you are welcome. Professor Ezima Nabife, my teacher, my lecturer, and of course, a member of the University Governing Council. Please let us appreciate her in a special way, because she's my teacher. We welcome you. Professor Ifeyinwa Emejulu is also here. We welcome you. We have Professor Ken Obi. Prof, we welcome you. Professor Allen Adum, we welcome you. Professor Patrick Adigwe is also here. We welcome you. Professor Jerry Emejulu is also here. Professor Chinedu Onyezbwe is also here. We salute you. Professor Ebelenwo Okoye, we welcome you. Professor Ike Odimegu, the American we see here. Sorry, we welcome you. No. Professor B.A.C. Obiefuna, I say again, no. Reverend Father Professor B.A.C. Obiefuna, we welcome you. No. Madikalela Akali, please, I don't know if I'm jumping any professor here. Please, we also have Professor Uche Ebeze. We salute you. We also have Professor Steve Ufaro. We welcome you. Please, if we have others, please, let us have the list. Please. Professor Abanus is also here. In short, he came before every other person. Sorry, we welcome. No, no, no. Please, may somebody assist us with more names so that we can salute. Professor Nkechi Esimono is also here. Please, let us appreciate her. Former Dean of the Faculty of Education. We salute you. I'm just struggling to recognize the faces. So we salute you. We recognize and welcome all our directors here present, the heads of departments, and in a special way, the members of the Faculty of Social Sciences. Please, may we appreciate us more now. And in particular, the Special Department of Sociology. I flown. May we also welcome our online audience. They are here in their hundreds and thousands. This afternoon they have already joined and they are watching us and smiling. So we appreciate them. Permit me also to welcome in a special way Chief Ken Ekwenugo. Chief Ken Ekwenugo is a great friend of the university and the leader in our community. We welcome you, sir. Beside him is our Chief Fred Chingoba, the chairman of Oka Committee of Friends at home and in diaspora. We used to call him Alufu America. Alufu, we welcome you all the way from Iwatago. I see again now. The CSO of our great university is also here, Chief Ken Chukura. We welcome you. And I just saw Professor Ken Mogu, the man that taught us this business in a special way. I salute you and we welcome you, sir. You are welcome. So we welcome all of us, please. More recognitions will be ongoing. So without wasting much of our time, may I also inform you that my name is Professor Frank Collins Okafor. The Dean, Faculty of Social Sciences. Thank you. And the University Orator for that matter. You know, I thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Mr. Chairman, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor and privilege to present and call to the high table, to the special table today, the man that will be presenting the 98th inaugural lecture of Nnamdi Azikiwe University. He will be properly introduced at the right time, but permit me to introduce in a special way the 98th inaugural lecturer of our great university, Professor Onuna Amarafia. He is Professor Nkemdili, AU, Nnonyelu, Okooka. And to come up with him is his beautiful wife, former First Lady of Awka South Local Government Area, Lady Nkiru Nnonyelu. Lady Nkiru Nnonyelu is a Deputy Registrar and Faculty Admin Officer, Faculty of Management Sciences, Nnamdi Azikiwe University, Awka. Because you have to do this. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. We now move on with the inaugural lecture proper. And on this note, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Chairman, sir, it is my honor and privilege to invite the chairman on today's event, and to the glory of God, the sixth substantive vice chancellor of Nnamdi Azikiwe University, Awka, Professor Charles Okechukwu Esimone, fellow Academy of Science, ably represented today by Professor Ufele, Angela Ufele, the Director of Academic Planning, Nnamdi Azikiwe University, to please come forward for the chairman's opening remarks and, of course, to declare the 98th inaugural lecture open. Vice Chancellor, sir.
University Orator. Good afternoon, everybody. I welcome all the professors, the directors, the deans, the HODs, and our visitors to Nnamdi Azikiwe University 98th inaugural lecture. We are very sorry for starting behind the schedule. I welcome all of you to this great event. Of course, today we are going to listen to Professor of Sociology, who will learn how to socialize. Today it will happen. So let us sit back and listen and enjoy the lecture. On behalf of Professor Charles Okechukwu Esimone, the Vice Chancellor of Nnamdi Azikiwe University, and on behalf of the University Senate, I hereby declare the 98th inaugural lecture open.
Thank you so much, Mr. Vice Chancellor, ably represented by Professor Angela
Ufele, the Director of Academic Planning, Nnamdi Azikiwe University. We salute you. We appreciate you, ma. Thank you so much for that short remarks. Mr. Chairman, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, kindly grant me the grace to also welcome the immediate past chair of our own dear ASU, Professor Steve Ufaro. I salute you. I welcome you. May I also welcome Professor Cornelius Ukweze, the head of Department of Mass Communication, Professor Theodora Onuko, my friend's teacher at Igwebike Grammar School. I welcome you. Professor Clementina Abuonu is also here. He's here with us, please. We welcome you. And also Professor E.O. Ezenweke, we welcome you. We'll continue to recognize our own dear participants. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, we are now at the right time when the jele masquerade will display. And for the jele to display, there must be umuobelobele man like us. Today, we want to have another young, resourceful fellow, a member of our faculty and associate professor of psychology, who will be presenting the 98th inaugural lecturer. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Chairman, it is my honor to invite Associate Professor Tochukwu Onyezidikene Ogwebwe to please come forward for the citation.
Vice Chancellor, ably represented by the Director of Academic Planning of our great university, members of the University Governing Council, members of the university management, members of the university community, the professors, our host community, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. This is a very brief citation of His Excellency Professor Nkemdili A.U. Nnonyelu, the District Governor-elect of Rotary International District 9142, and the Pro-Chancellor of Peter University, One and Chinanambra State. With your permission, Mr. Vice-Chancellor of this greatest university of the moment, Nnamdi Azikiwe University, Oka, may I most respectfully, with every sense of humility, responsibility, and monumental pleasure, invite a colossus of industrial relations, a legendary scholar of sound mind and body, an eloquent speaker, a soldier of Christ, a defender of the people, an astute grassroots politician, Professor Nkemdili A.U. Nnonyelu, a professor of industrial relations in the Department of Sociology and Anthropology of Nnamdi Azikiwe University, to please remain upstanding. In his wisdom, Warren Bennis opined that the most dangerous leadership might is that leaders are born. In the wake of this danger, on 12th of December 1962, Professor A.U. Nnonyelu was born to his parents in the city of Awka in Anambra State, Nigeria. As he is fondly called Professor A.U., he obtained a West African Secondary School Certificate from Government Secondary School, AFIBO, in 1979, General Certificate Examination, GCE, in 1980, BSc Sociology and Anthropology, MSc Industrial Sociology, and PhD in Industrial Relations from University of Nigeria Nsukka between 1984, 1988, and 2004, respectively. Because leadership is driven by service and service to the people, Professor AU has served humanity in many capacities within and outside the university. Within the university at various times, His Excellency, the District Governor-elect of Rotary International, has served the university as two-time head Department of Sociology and Anthropology, sub-dean of the Faculty of Social Sciences, Dean Faculty of Social Sciences, Chairman Housing University Housing Committee, Chairman University Community Relations, Chairman Committee on Naming of Streets, Roads, and Buildings on Campus, Chairman Committee on the Publication of University Brochure, Chairman Committee of Launching of the University History Book, Member of various Vice Chancellor's Committees, University Orator, Dean Student Affairs, Director Continuing Education Program, CEP, Director UNISIC Business School, where he played a significant and key role in the rejuvenation of the school and its movement to the current location. A two-term member of the University Governing Council and currently Director Emeka Anyaoku Institute for International Studies and Diplomacy. As Albert Schweitzer submitted that example is not the main thing in influencing others, but is the only thing. Prof. AU has impacted the state, the local government, and the Church of Christ with his exemplary leadership skills and touch of transformation. As a member of Oka Traditional Royal Cabinet with the title of Oko Oka, Prof. AU served at different times as Commissioner for Education in Anambra State, Special Advisor on Ecology and Environment to the then Governor of Anambra State, Chairman Transition Committee, Oka South Local Government, Chairman, Anambra State Housing Development Corporation, and sincerely, to mention but a few. Oka Oka! All the brief. Oka Oka has served as the immediate past president of Nigerian Anthropological and Sociological Practitioners Association between 2018 to 2023. And is currently the Pro-Chancellor and Chairman Governing Council, Peter University at Chinaone of Anambra State, Nigeria. He has supervised many successful doctoral and other postgraduate students, and to his credit, has a host of academic publications in reputable national and international journals. He is an author of many books of contemporary issues in sociology and industrial relations, external examiner for undergraduates, MSc and PhD programs in various universities and at different times. He has served the National University Commission at numerous times as chairman of accreditation panels, a fellow of numerous professional bodies and associations, a man of many accolades who is a recipient of many recognition and awards, both from students' bodies, professional bodies, Rotary International Community, and the Church of Christ. It is better to fail in originality than to succeed in imitation. And either you run the day or the day runs you. Professor AU Nnonyelu has maintained originality in running his days with an unprecedented, avid disposition in championing the cause of the people. He is the mouthpiece of the oppressed, a leader par excellence, a paragon of oratory, a pathfinder, a sociological pace setter, an administrative genius, a reservoir of knowledge, an idol in unionism, a loyal husband to his beautiful wife, and a loving father to his four children. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir. My Deputy Vice Chancellor, I recognize your presence. Permit me, sir, to invite for this inaugural lecture this towering personality, a refined gentleman, a source of inspiration to many, a supersonic academic icon of repute, a man very just in reasoning, fair in his judgment, upright in all matters, willing to support all good ideas, firm and courageous, a pro-chancellor and district governor-elect of Rotary International District 9412, His Excellency Professor Nkemdili, AU Nnonyelu, for your inaugural lecture.
Let every good man raise his helmet and glove, leaving a Rotary to carry a message of service and love, leaving a Rotary.
the Vice Chancellor, my very good friend, Professor Charles Okechukwu Simone, Fellow Academy of Science, ably represented today. Well, there's another representation here now, supplanting of the original representative. The representative of the VSA is now here. Professor Joseph, my very good friend again, Ikechebel. Prof, I welcome you. He just rushed in straight from Abuja. In fact, even with delayed flight, he managed to make it. Thank you, Prof, for being here. The wife of the Vice Chancellor and my girlfriend. That's true. That is the truth. She is a very, very prayerful woman, very kind woman. I thank you. I thank you. Please convey my regards to the VC. The DAP. May I please ask for your permission to rest on the already well-established protocol by the university orator. And I will also want to crave your indulgence to please stand. Not like my friend did 2 days ago. I'm going to talk about that. I'm not asking for any prayers, 1 minute prayers, but I'm asking you to stand because of what we have come to do today. And I will, with the audacity of today, call on my friend, Arinza Abanusi, as my friend, also the leader of this country, did in Chatham House. I'm going to share responsibilities today. I'm going to share responsibilities. I'll ask my friend, Arinza, to please lead us in the solidarity song. That's the first thing for us to say today.
Let's go. When the union's inspiration through the workers' blood shall run, there can be no power greater anywhere beneath the sun. Yet what force on earth is weaker than the feeble strength of one? But the union makes us strong. Soli, soli, soli. Soli, soli. So, 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 so. They have taken untold billions that they never thought to end. But without a brain, a muscle, nor a single will could turn, we can break their haughty power, gain our freedom when we learn that our union makes us strong. Soli, soli, soli. Soli, soli. So, 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 so. It is we who plow the prairies, built the cities where they trade, dug the mines and built the workshops, endless miles of railroad led. Now we stand at cast and still we miss the wonders we have made. But the union makes us strong. Soli, soli, soli. Soli, soli. So, 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 so. In our hands is placed a power greater than the hoarded gold, greater than the might of armies magnified a thousandfold. We can bring to birth a new world from the ashes of the old, for the union makes us strong. Soli, soli, soli. Soli, soli. So, 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 so. In Soleto, in Africa, Alota continua.
Thank you so very much. This is how to start an inaugural that the topic of the inaugural is about our union. From classroom teachers, researchers, to what? Union activists. The predicament of academics in Nigerian public universities. Mr. Vice Chancellor, today I am on the hot seat. I did not know that there's going to be any time that I walk into the auditorium and people would gather just to listen to me, even though that I hear from friends, senators in this university. Now, whenever I miss a Senate meeting, they will say that my absence was very conspicuous. But today, I come in measured steps. I came to do what I'm told is in the tradition of our university. For a new professor, newly elevated professor, to mount the rostrum to present what is called an inaugural. I am not a linguist, but I know that by the definition of inaugural, it means the commencement of one's professorship. That's what I'm told. And it is a lifelong experience, the summit, the peak of your professorship. That is what a professor is, or who a professor should be. That is zenith of academic achievement in the university. So for an inaugural, it must be a very sweet experience, a time that we usually say should come with all manner of celebration. That's what an inaugural should be. It is, like the orator said, the unveiling of what? An Ijele masquerade. But if the Ijele, or whatever he is or she is been in the village square for quite some time, I don't know what you're unveiling. I don't know what you'll be unveiling. But it is an opportunity for the inaugural presenter, the lecturer, to trace what I call the trajectory, the intellectual or academic odyssey, or the peregrination of that lecturer from beginning till where he is. An opportunity for you to express the profundity of your thoughts, the clarity of your thoughts, what you've done, and what also should constitute your beliefs, your practices, your orientations, your character. All of them should be on display. Because for me, personally, character is also very important. When you talk about achievement in academics, it must be there. So today, an inaugural should be a celebration of sorts. Yes, that's what it should be. And recently, it's been turned into some kind of feast-making. That when you come to an inaugural, you see lots and lots of celebration. That's what it should be. Ordinarily, that's what it should be. A time to show gratitude to your college of hosting the university. And I want to use this opportunity to thank you for taking that invitation from the Vice Chancellor. In other words, what it means is that at the end of this ceremony, if there is food to eat, the person who invited you is the VC. You go to him to take some food. And the inaugural lecture committee. I'm also told that my department wanted to do something like that. Because I said I wasn't going to do any of that. But what I will do is to excite us for us to talk about where we are today as university academics. Because that's the essence of my presentation. Only. And at the end of the day, we can just take it from there. My dear friends, Mr. Vice Chancellor, not only because it's been quite some time that my professorship came on board. That may be it. But primarily, today's event is tamed down because of what we have seen in terms of the presentation, the nature of the society today, 133 million Nigerians and multidimensional poverty. 133 million. You can imagine what it means. And I am told too, I have been told even 20 years ago, that our take-home pay cannot take us home. And I also remember that 8 months last year, we are still being owed our what? Salaries. We have not been paid. So because of these conspiracy of factors, combination of factors, and then lastly, the demographic factor, age. I'm no longer a young person. If you watch my gray hair, you notice that I'm no longer young. It's not the usual zest, gusto, you know, whatever that you find in AU, that you find these days. I'm quite, you know, coming down. So because of that, I said that today's inaugural should be a very quiet one. And I plead for your understanding that that is in keeping with the new mood of the country. And more so, the inaugural committee did something that was not very palatable. I must complain, because I begged them, begged and begged, that I would be given the latitude to present my inaugural on Tuesday. On Tuesday, I wrote a letter to that effect. They said it is impossible to do that inaugural on Tuesday. And you know me, I'm a man under authority. Whenever they speak, I lie low. So I said, well, if that is the university tradition, let me go to Thursday, because 2 days ago I turned 61, you know. So I thought they were going to allow me that privilege to celebrate my birthday. So all that I would have brought today for stomach infrastructure, all of them ended on Tuesday. I'm sure Emeka's on, he will bear me witness. Yeah. Then, having said that, and with your permission, let me, before we go into the lecture proper, just briefly go through my early childhood years for those who are not well informed about where we are coming from. I thank Dr. Chukwu Ogwebe. By the way, the Vice President of NASA is here, Professor Agnes Njoku. She came from, and the fellow of NASA, from Imo State University. And the immediate past Vice President, Chiemeka Onyema, is also here. So I want to welcome them specially. Apart from other friends that are here, because I'm also, that is my association. And I just handed over after 5 years as national president. My childhood years, my dear friends, evidently, you know, when you see me, you know I wasn't born with any golden spoon. Not even a silver or bronze spoon. Not any of them. You know, born in somewhere here around Oka, inside Oka, inside Umuzocha, Yes. To a polygamous home, Nnonyelu and Nemo, as a worker Lando family, as the last in a polygamous home. And nothing in view of the immensity of scarcity in those days, you know, would give you any cause to celebrate. I'm sure Chiedu Nyizuba and the others will be waiting to hear this. But the main reason was actually, if you were born very, you know, just before the Civil War, like some of us, 62 to 66, 67, and as a toddler, you were faced with an experience that you can't even talk about. When I see internally displaced persons today, I just remember what happened in those days. People like Harris, they wouldn't know what I'm talking about. You know. Anybody after 70 wouldn't know what we are talking about. So, in any case, the war was just something else. And you know, because of Oka, the strategic nature of Oka, it was a place that the federal soldiers wanted to capture immediately. And they went in there. The language Bonausa Batoka. And so we fled with my eldest brother. In fact, my eldest brother is in his late 80s. He should have been here today. He was the secretary to the vice chancellors, four successive vice chancellors at University of Nigeria Nsukka, before he became the personnel officer. He was the person taking us from Oka to Ekulobia, Ekulobia to Olu, until we finally landed in Umuahua, and that was where we settled. But one thing that is striking about my experience, childhood experience, is something that happened during the war, which I still remember. We are two of us, myself and my very good friend, another friend of mine, who just retired from the bank. We went for, what do they call it? Palm Nut, whatever, searching. Mkbaku. Yes, as we were there moving around, we heard a loud, loud noise, very loud. And it was the bombing of the quarters, the camp, where we were, the entire family, and all of that. However, two infants running in the bush. What we now saw looking up was an airplane fighting us from on top of the tree, firing on us. We are just lucky. I thought it was a dream or a nightmare. I didn't see my friend until after 25, 30 years after the war. And what, immediately we saw ourselves, the first thing we remembered was that experience. That told me that, so this thing was real. You can imagine the cruelty of the Nigerian Federal Armed Forces in those days. Side by side, that cruelty. You saw the intervention of the Caritas, the Red Cross, when they were supplying us with all the things we needed to make us survive and to be free from what? Kwashiorkor. The young persons wouldn't know about this, but it was something serious. So that angelic intervention was very good. Immediately after the war, we left, thanks to my eldest brother, to Nsukka. And I must say, my dear friends, that was a paradigm shift. Because I'm told that even, not that I'm told, you can imagine a developed village like Oka, and you can imagine in my village I'm still the only professor. So perhaps if I didn't make that move, I would have been somewhere with my Ogene and all of that. Perhaps. You can't talk about providence. Perhaps. I went into a university primary school. That was where my first real experience of formal education. Because everything we did during the war was not real experience. You can't talk about it seriously. But we didn't last. I didn't last there. because of the exigencies of the post-war effects, I had to move immediately over to Urban Primary School, Nsukka. And from Urban Primary School, I took my common entrance, went to Government Secondary School, Afigbo, which was then an Ivy League college. Fear God. Yes, I'm sure Romeo is here. Where is OK? Is there another? Who said, I heard Honor the King from there? Another person from Afigbo. OK. Romeo is here. So that's our motto. Discipline, very, very, very interesting school. One of the best schools anybody can dream of. In fact, because of that experience in Government College, Afigbo, my ambition in life is to have a college, and that I've not been able to do because of scarcity of resources. I wanted to replicate my experience in Government College, Afigbo. One other funny and not funny experience, you know, you remember it with a lot of gratitude to God. In 1978, when I was going back to Government College, Afigbo, from Nsukka, where we were living, after moving from Nsukka to Enugu, Enugu to Okigwe, Okigwe to Afigbo, station wagon, as it's called, we had a head-on collision with an MCC loaded with gravel. And you know what happened. Ghastly fatal, except for me. Every other person in that vehicle died. I'm telling you. So when I remember this, I said, there must be a reason that God kept you alive. And from there, I moved to University of Nigeria, the den of lions and lionesses. Great lions. Great lions. Everybody is dwarfed by Aztec here. You can imagine. We all dwarfed. Yeah? By NAU.